Hey there, it's Lauren, owner of Imagined Awakenings, and I am ready to get creative with some resin. As always, safety first. Remember to use your safety gear when working with epoxy resin and work in a well-ventilated area. All right, so this week, I am using one of my large geo tray molds. These are some of my favorites. I absolutely love this shape. And here you can just see me fiddling around with my obnoxiously large jar of broken glass. I actually think what I bought was like for fireplaces, or I can't remember what. No, fire pits maybe. But it's the smaller version. But I mean, it came in such huge jars. I was like, why would I not buy it? Anywho, so I like to place some broken glass around the very edges, and then also around the center hole there. And what I like to do is I kind of lay it down so that it doesn't come higher than the mold, than the edges of the mold, so that when I pour all of my resin in, that the glass is completely covered and sealed in the resin and there's none like sticking up, because I want it to be a beautiful yet usable tray. Alrighty. All right, here I'm just getting my colorants together because you know I like to do that beforehand. And so here I am using a blue mica powder and I believe a silver glitter, and I'm just gonna dump it in the bottom of the cup along with some popsicle sticks for stirring. And now I'm going to combine my resins. I use Counterculture DIY. I really should actually, I'm gonna start tagging it in the video. Oh my God, don't call and text when I'm trying to do a video voiceover. Okay, anyway. So I actually pour apart B first, which is the hardener, and then I pour apart A, which is the resin. Be sure I got that right. And it was a suggestion made by the manufacturer. I guess they're the manufacturer, distributor, whatever they are. They suggest because it makes it easier to stir that way, and so far I have found that to be the case. And it seems to be less bubbly when I go to stir it. Also, I tend to place both jugs in some warmish water for, I don't know, 15 minutes or so before I pour. It just seems to loosen it up a bit and makes the whole process go a little smoother. So tips, yay for tips. And then they recommend, most resin manufacturers or distributors or whatever they are, I should really look that up so I just sound, you know, a little bit more educated when I'm talking. Anyway, they have about a time frame for how long it should take to stir it all together to come up with the correct mixture, get it all. Oh my God, it is thundering outside. Sorry, distraction, squirrel. Anyway, back to what I was saying. They usually tell you about how long to stir until it's clear. When it's a clear homogeneous mixture, that's when you know it is ready. So this takes about 5 minutes. I usually maybe do six because I'm a little obsessive and I just want to make sure it's completely combined together. So it's a wonderful clear color. I don't know if it's clear as a color, is it? No, but it's wonderfully clear in the consistency. Has a nice a looser consistency once it's all mixed together. And so there I just poured some resin into the cups with the colorants in there, and here I'm just going to pour kind of a thin layer on the bottom of this one because this one is going to be a moon tray. Yay. So I'm pouring a thin layer on the bottom and just kind of making sure it's all covered. I also dumped some glitter in there. I don't know if you noticed that, but I dumped some glitter in there before I did the pouring. And so here I am just placing my moons that I've already cured into the resin I've already poured. The reason I started doing it this way was when I tested two or three of these before I decided I liked them. And what I found is when I don't pour a layer of resin on the bottom before I put the moons in, it shows like it's a noticeable contrast. Because it doesn't completely cover the bottom. Like some parts of the moons will be covered and some won't. And so I just want to make sure the whole thing is covered and has a seamless look. Otherwise it's going to drive me up a wall. So then I took the rest of the resin and covered the top of the moons so that they would be all covered and sealed within the tray. And here I'm just going to mix all of my colors together for the geo tray. And I've noticed that I like simple with these, so I only do like, you know, two or three colors. And so I take the clear here with glitter in it, of course, and I'm just gonna pour it over the broken glass because I like to make sure the broken glass is covered, as I stated before. So I'm gonna do that with both sections of broken glass, and then I'm going to add my blue and just kind of alternate until I like the way it looks. Oh, that was such a mouthful. I had some additional resin left over that would not fit inside the trays. I've had some recent projects in which I realized it is terrible to overfill the mold. I already know this. I don't know why I did it. Anywho, you'll see it in the future. Anyway, so smartly, I decided not to overfill these molds. And so I had enough to make another piece. And so I just poured the additional resin in the unicorn. So here I'm kind of going for like a smoky, wispy, cloudy effect. And so I dropped some white alcohol ink in the clear resin. I just kind of swirl it around. I saw this done by some other YouTube professionals and it looked beautiful and fabulous. So this isn't the first time I've done it, but it's a technique that I like. So I went ahead and added the white there, and then I'm gonna go and add usually with alcohol ink, you just add color first and then white on top. And then you can do as many layers as you want. I usually just do one because I don't know. I just do one. but in this scenario here, you put white in there first, swirl around, and then you put color in, and then you go back over with white. Okay, so that's what I'm doing here. And in this one, I use purple and black. Of course, with the white, the black tends to look a lot more grayish. And so here with the unicorn, I decided to just use, you know, the same colors, you know, I think mostly just purple in this case, though. I don't think I use the black, just because, you know, keep it simple, right? It's my favorite. So I also had some additional color left from the geo piece with the broken glass. And so I had some other molds. It's like a thing that I'm obsessive mold buyer. So that when I have excessive resin, it doesn't get wasted. Yay. So these molds are like a crystal. They look like crystal. Tea light holder. That's what they are. I was gonna say something else completely wrong. So they're like crystal shaped tea light holders. First time I've ever used them. Super excited to try them out. right, and as usual, I'm just gonna hit it with a heat gun. Get out all those bubbles that have floated to the top. Smooth everything out. Make sure it's nice and pretty. And then I will get ready to let it sit. I usually let it sit overnight. It doesn't actually sit a full 24 hours because I put a little heater in front of it because I'm super impatient, but it's nice and fully hardened by the time I demold it. So here we are. They are all ready. So let me just tell you about these stupid molds. I swore that I would never use them again. The sabotager, that's my youngest son, for y'all that don't know, was even trying to help me. He was like, maybe if you try this, Mom, maybe if you do this. Because, like, literally, I was like 45 minutes trying to get this stupid thing out of here. Like, I guess it's the shape, because it's a rather deep mold, but it's also super firm. I mean, which is good, because you don't want no flimsy mold that's going to tear. But, you know, I mean, it was like, I guess it had to be He-Man to get that thing out of there. So, you know, I tried and tried, got frustrated, set it down, tried and tried, and I was like, forget it, F this. I'm just going to take another piece out. So I took a break because it was killing my hands. And I decided to go ahead and demold the Crescent Moon Unicorn, because why not? It's pretty. Just to see what I have here. And I really love the effect and the way that came out. All full of glitter and wonder and beautiful purple alcohol ink. Yes, I'm a fan. All right, and then I went back to it. I was like, I'm gonna eventually have to get this stupid thing out of here. Jesus. So I went back to fighting with it. I believe I did cut this so that you did not. Yeah, I did. So did you not have to suffer through the entirety of me fighting with this? Because I assure you it was longer than this video suggests. So I finally did, after all my pain and suffering and waiting, get that thing out of there. And I mean, it was a tight fit. Like it was sticking to certain places. And I was like, I never want to see these molds again. I was like this close. You can't see my fingers, but I was this close to throwing them things away. I did not throw them away because I don't hardly throw away anything. I might be a pack rat. But oh Lord, I finally got it out of there. Okay, and admittedly, they did turn out pretty, but why the mold have to be stupid? Like, I haven't used those since, by the way. Maybe I thought about it the other day, but then it just didn't happen. So anyway, I just cut that short and I took the other one out so you can see it. I kind of like the mix of the clear glittery resin with the mica powder resin. I thought that had a pretty effect in that. If only they didn't take 3 hours to get out the mold. Okay, so anywho, next up is the geode with the broken glass. I totally just love that technique. Like, I just love the way it turns out. My last video had one. It was purpley though. This one's blue. Anyway, so luckily that one's a lot easier to demold. And that's the back, and that's the top, and the front, and I just love it. I mean, so shimmery, so glittery. So thought about keeping it for myself, but I did not. I did post it on the website. But yeah, love the effect with the broken glass and the glitter and the mica powder. Love, love, love. I'm a fan. All right, last but not least, the moon tray. That is last, right? Yeah. Last but not least, the moon tray. Luckily, another that is very easy to demold. Just comes right off. Yay, why can't they all do that? Anyway, so yes, with all the glitter and the sparkle and the moons and the alcohol ink, huge fan. Loved it. I should do some more. I have to make some more moons, though. Maybe you'll see me doing some more moons soon. So, thanks for dropping by. Appreciate you sticking with me. If you like what you've seen, feel free to subscribe. And I will see you all later.